Welcome back, my friends. In today's video, we're gonna paint the second part of this landscape painting here, the mill and the water part. Yeah, just to show you again, the other painting, basically just two colors for the water and another one for the greens here. Then I start to mix the colors for the windmill. We have here a very strange angle here from the camera, therefore it looks pretty distorted, but in reality it looks not that off, as you can see here now. Just a very short clip about this thing. I know that most of you are here for the water part, therefore same goes for the greens here. It appears to be green, but we have lots of different colors here. The reddish ones, the more cooler greens, the warmer greens. Ton of details. Basically it's a very dark overall tone here. And I'm also using the background color. This is dry now for the, basically also for the second layer. Then I level out the line between the water and the greens here. We have a soft transition, not this hard edged stuff here. Then I start to build up the details here, the water line. And we have on the first part here, we have this kind of stippled water effect. Then I start to build up the details of the shadows of the mill here. And what you need to do is here, you need to basically hint the ripples, the little waves that we have here coming in. And this is done by following the direction of the ripples and connecting them with the shadow of the mill. Here I measure up the height of the shadow. Basically it's darkish color here. And we have those ripples here on the side. And then I start to build up the rest of the ripples on the left and right side of the shadow. As you can see here, it's very very fine brush, colors thinned down quite a bit. And I do this to achieve a very, very detailed effect of those ripples here. And then I use a blender brush to soften down the edges. And that's basically what I do all over the painting, more or less, as you can see here. The ripples get a bit lighter on the right side, and you need to put the ripples in according to the line of the horizon, more or less. They need to look right, if you know what I mean. Then I start to build up the connection from the dry underpainting, the lighter area here, and the darker area that we have in the front. This is again done with the dry brush technique, as you can see here. Just a little detail of the mill to show you how easy it is to build up those wings here. Colors thin down quite a bit, and very sharp brush. And then I start to build up those leaves on the water that we have here. Make sure that you put in those parts here, smaller in the back and smaller on the right side. As we have the perspective coming in. And also make sure that you use different colors. You can see here we have lighter ones, warmer ones, darker ones. And they all become bigger the more you step to the front. And they also need to be a bit chaotic in places, more or less. Different sizes, different shapes. And then you need to add some shadows beneath them. I mean, not overall, not on all the leaves here, but yeah, some of them need to have those shadows beneath the water, a bit beneath the body of the leaf. And this really helps to communicate the volume of those leaves and gets just in more details and more realism, more or less. And here part where we have special chaos, more or less. You see down the shapes not really nice that well anymore, but and I then go over the whole leaves, at least parts of them, where we have even more light shining, reflecting on them. And then we come to the foreground, and then we have basically leaves that vanish into the water. And to achieve this, you just need to dry brush on the color very soft, in a very thin layer. So that basically the leaf appears to be floating and partially disappearing into the water by just adding a thinner layer of color on these areas where the water over the leaf becomes thicker. Adding some more detail here, there. Then we start to build up the reeds and the grass and the other stuff detail here. You see, I'm using different colors here. This reddish brownish tone, green tone here, and different brush sizes, as you can see here. Bigger one for the bigger leaves and sharper one, thinner one, bit more shaped like a knife for the smaller ones. And you see I mix the colors while I'm going, and this is one of the key parts here. It's not done with just one color, you need different greens, warmer ones, colder ones. Very fine details here and there, and we even have those reddish tones here for the reeds in the foreground. And then we do the same on the right side. We have here more grass parts, more reeds, more or less. And you see, again, we have tons of variation size-wise, color-wise, and we're done.
So, that's it for today, but make sure you check out, before you leave, one of these two other videos here.